All right, problem 52 off the math subject GRE practice test. Finally, an easier problem. The last few have been kind of brutal, and the next one's terrible, too. But this one's not too bad, I guess if you like combinatorics, which I do. So what's going on here is we have a math department that has 10 professors, and the department's going to offer 20 courses. And the question is, how many different ways can the courses be assigned to the professors? And I think the easiest way to think about it is assign the courses based on tenure. Right, so whoever's been there the longest gets to choose first. So I'm super old. I've been teaching there forever. I get first choice of my classes. Right, so how many choices do I have? Well, for the first class that I teach, I have 20 choices. And for the next class that I pick, there's only 19 classes left because I already selected, combinatorics because I like that stuff. And then I was like, I need a break. Give me algebra. And that was my second one here. And so this is the number of choices I have? No, not quite. I have to divide by two because if I choose calculus or combinatorics first and then algebra second, that's the exact same as if I choose algebra first and combinatorics second as far as what my teaching assignment is. So this right here kind of represents how many different choices I have choosing first. And then somebody else steps up and she's old, but she ain't as old as me. She haven't been there quite as long, but she's been there for a while. So she gets to choose, and she's like, I want combinatorics. I'm like, too bad, I already took it. And she's like, oh, bummer, I can't choose that class. In fact, I can't choose that or algebra. For the 20 classes, only 18 are left. So she has 18 choices for her first class and then 17 for her second. And again, we've got to divide by two because if she chooses Calc 1 and then Calc 2, that gives her the same assignment as if she chooses Calc 2 and then Calc 1. And hopefully you can see where this is going. The next person would have 16 classes, then 15 classes, but we got to divide by two. And so on all the way until some newbie that just got hired last term takes the leftovers. And he feels like he has a choice. He's like, well, I got two choices for one of my classes and then one for the other class. I'm like, yeah, dummy, you don't really have two choices, though, because there are two classes and you're teaching both of them. You got to divide by two. You're taking the leftovers regardless. So what do we end up with here? Well, in the numerator, 20 times 19 times 18 times 17, that looks a lot like 20 factorial. In the denominator, just a whole bunch of twos. How many twos do we have? Well, there were 10 different factors, is that the right word here? Because there are 10 different professors. So I have 10 of these fractions that I'm multiplying together. What I'm trying to say is I got 10 of these twos. So this is the expression I'm looking for here. There it is, A. That'd be the answer to this question.